So the first thing I'm going to do is just put a little bit more colour through the neck, just to get some of this texture to show up a touch more. So I'm just re-wetting with clean water this whole area. And then I'm going to drop in some very light ochre greys just into that wet area, just to get some of that texture to show up a bit more. And then just wash it away at the bottom. And then continuing into the body of the wing. So I'm going to add some clean water back into the wing. And then add some more colour just to start to develop these shapes a bit more. Thinking about it being domed. So just re-wet that wing area. I'm now going to drop in some of the cerulean-y colours. And again, pop a little bit of the purples, purpley blues. Very washy though, so I don't want it to be too strong. So very dilute into an already dilute area, so it should give me a very light wash. So just into this wing first, bringing these blues up and over. Bit of broken colour there. A few more bluey marks. Bluey purples. Tiny bit of the yellow in there as well as the purples. Grey it a touch more. And then just soften some of those marks down. Dark in here. And again, just soften that with just some clean water. Bring a little bit more of that just through here. Might even have a little bit of those same bluey greys down in the front here. And then continuing that same theme, a bit more yellow. A bit more yellow and purple, so it's slightly browner. Again, plenty of water. Maybe just a tiny bit of burnt sienna in there as well, just to warm that up. Again, pretty dilute. Add a bit of warmth back into some of these areas. Just to get some of that colour up into these wings. Wing feathers, I should say. And then I'm going to soften this all in, just using some water. A little bit more up here. To get them to show up. As we need some colour on there for the feathers to be apparent. A bit of blue in there. Not worried about making them individual feathers. I just want them to sort of feel more rounded. Maybe this wing here is a bit bluer. Slightly more purple in there. Slightly darker. Now a little bit of colour into the body, again with the yellowy colours onto dry paper. Just to get some of these textures to show up. Don't want to lose all my nice whites. Try and keep some of it still pretty white. A little bit more purple. Purple down here, purpley through there. A bit bluer. Just work those into the reflection a little bit, give a little bit of movement to those washes. A bit of the ripples in the water. Perhaps a couple on this side. Darken it up here a bit. A bit more tone, much more purple, a little bit of orange in the purple, get a bit more tone where the bird is meeting the water edge, a little bit more there. And just going to get some of that on over on this side. Just a few bits of this in here. And then maybe I'll just soften off this so you don't really get a line, just let it evaporate. Same on this side, just let that evaporate. Keep that nice and soft. Perhaps a little bit more colour, just on the body. Down near the tail here. Really lots of water in this. It's just a kind of a grey. Bit of purple. Some of the blues. Lots and lots of water. Just to give an indication of slightly less white. Just in there, perhaps a little bit here. It's going to cauliflower, unfortunately, never mind. Put a few darks back in there. And then just need a little bit more tone in the eye. And then go back into my very dark colours, which was the indigo. So indigo and burnt sienna. Just get that a bit darker. And using a smaller brush, just gonna wet part of the eye fold and drop a teeny bit of this colour in, don't want too much. Want to try and darken up. Just the front edge of the eye a little bit more. A little bit more tone in the muzzle beak area. So that's a lot darker. Just in here. Coming down. And then we're a lot darker under the beak. Just in there. Okay, now I'm going to give that a quick dry off.
Thank you.
some of these little whitey areas down here aren't quite working, so I'm just going to pop a bit more colour through those. Some of the slightly purpley greeny colours, a little bit more muted. Just to lose a little bit of that whiteness. And a little spray. Seeing as we've got a reflection in that area, a shadow I should say. Needs to come a bit darker. So looking at the picture again after having a little break, I feel as though I want to come a bit darker in the background here, keeping this area light but get a bit more dark through this side, and then I need a few more breaks in colour in the wing. I wet my area through here. Because I want this whole piece to get darker. So I'm just re-wetting all over there. And then I'm going to tip the colour in from this point. So the colour I'm going for is the blue again, but much stronger this time. A little bit of the yellow in it, more blue. So here we go. So I'm going to start to tip the colour in from here. Oh. So this is very, very strong colour now. I want it to go all the way along that edge. More blue. Just keep tipping it till we get over here. Gonna let it run all the way back towards this side, popping in a little bit of water around here just to bleed that out around the head. Just to soften it off there. Just drop my brush, that's clever. I'm just washing it out a little bit around the head. Tissue. Just to wipe that up. I need to tip the board that way. Now I need to very quickly just soften all this off. And this edge. I may even put a couple of little bits of water just to give a feathery edge in there. Now before this wash dries out, I'm going to add a bit more blue, maybe slightly darker blue, some of the Prussian in there, the indigo. Continue this across. I want this side of the painting to be much darker. Bringing this down, more blue. And then before it dries out, I'm going to take some of my transparent yellow, fairly thick, try a piece of that up here. And again, I'm going to wash that in and around the head. Wash that out. So I tip that a little bit more down. Hold on to it for a moment. Going to wipe the edge just to stop those runbacks. Tip it down a little bit. Yellow just to creep across a bit more. Okay, so I'll put that back on the stand. Make sure that's the right way. Going to peel off the masking fluid now. That's better. Just want a warmish grey colour, so I'm just going to indicate a few of these little feathery shapes. So it's more the underside of the feather that I want to try and indicate the bit that's casting the shadow. And obviously they overlap quite a lot. I'm not going to try and paint every single one, but just to give the impression that there's some very soft shadowy colours in here. So I'm just running the damp brush to take away some of the edges. keep it soft. You can do as much or as little of this detail work. The more you do, obviously, the tighter the image will get. But you will need a little bit to break up some of those larger areas or masses of white. Some grey little spots here and there. A few dots. Just to work that wing. Perhaps a few light greys to indicate these feathers that are very soft. More water into that same mix, so it's very, very dilute now. Just want to pick out a few possible shapes that suggest overlapping feathers. So very, very pale. Few longer strokes, perhaps a bit more grey. So these strokes are quite, these lines for these wing bits. A little bit darker in there, and then these feathers up here are actually behind the wing in front, so they need to come a bit darker. So I'll just cut some of those in. Make a little bit more of this shadow here. Again, a bit more dilute, just give the indication of some of these feathers back here, a little bit of tone there, a bit more tone along this edge, and then here. Shadowy colours. Just using the Payne's Grey here to layer up some of these marks. Darken these up a bit. And then the indication of some tail feathers. A bit more grey as it comes down to where the waterline is. Touch darker. And then a little bit of yellow in there. Very dilute. Just some very light yellowy indications. Again, just to break up some of this larger area. I'm not really trying to paint individual feathers as such. More just to give the illusion of feathers. It's a fairly dark grey, dark. Just going to drop some of these in. Just to accent the waterline and also create some of these. And there we go. I believe that'll do us.